In this session of GPET Kaksha, we will learn about half-life. Half-life is the time in which the concentration of drug in plasma is reduced to 50% of its original value. Means, for example, initially if the drug concentration is 100 milligram and after half-life its concentration will be 50 milligram, means just 50% of its initial concentration during the half-life. Half-life is the time and it is different for different drugs. It is derived from volume of distribution and clearance. Half-life is derived from volume of distribution and clearance, which are two primary parameters. As we have already discussed in previous sessions, that volume of distribution and clearance are the fundamental pharmacokinetic parameters or the primary kinetic parameters. Okay, volume of distribution and clearance. So half-life is derived from volume of distribution and clearance, hence it is a secondary parameter. Since it is derived from two primary parameters, so it is secondary parameter. Okay, if the rate of metabolism of a drug is more, if a rate of metabolism of a drug is more, half-life is less, because if a drug is metabolizing too fast, so in a short interval of time it will get depleted out of the body. So in that case half-life is less. Okay, and if the rate of metabolism is less, then half-life is more. Means if a drug is metabolizing at a very slow pace, then after a very long time of interval, it will get depleted out of the body. So its half-life will be long. And if metabolism is fast, half-life will be short. Half-life helps to determine various parameters. For example, it helps to determine the time interval between two doses or dosing interval. Whenever our physician prescribes a drug, he or she says that you have to take the next dose after 8 hours. So where from this 8 hours has appeared? This is the dosing interval, means it is the time interval between two doses. Means he or she knows that after 8 hours the drug will be below its therapeutic concentration, means it will be at that concentration at which it is unable to show its therapeutic effect. Hence it is necessary to take the second dose. So this parameter of 8 hours appears from half-life, that how much amount of concentration will remain after 8 hours. Means it is derived from half-life, that after one half-life this concentration will be 50% of initial concentration, after next half-life what will be the concentration. So at that particular time when the concentration is below the therapeutic concentration, the next dose is required to be taken, and that can be derived with the help of half-life. Secondly, it helps to determine the frequency of dosing. Means how frequently a drug should be taken. Once a day, twice a day, thrice a day. Okay, so that particular dosing interval is depend upon this, that particular frequency of once a day. Okay, once a day OD, twice a day BISINDI, BID, or thrice a day. So these words we see in prescription, OD, BID, TURINDI, TID. So these comes from where? These parameters are determined from the half-life of the drug, that a drug is need to be taken once a day, twice a day, or thrice a day. If a drug has a longer half-life, it is need to be administered less frequently. As we have already discussed, that if a drug has longer half-life means its metabolism is less, means its retention in body is for a longer period of time. Hence, it is required to be taken less frequently inside the body. And if the drug having short half-life means drug is getting depleted very fast from the body or it is getting removed very fast from the body, it is need to be taken more frequently because soon the concentration will be below the therapeutic concentration. So the frequency of dose administration is more in case of short half-life. It helps to determine the time required to reach the steady state concentration. Steady state concentration is the concentration above which the administration of drug do not further rises the concentration and it reaches a constant value. Means after a particular concentration, the drug plasma drug concentration becomes constant. So this plateau indicates the steady state plasma concentration. It takes 4 to 5 half-lives for a drug to reach steady state. Means for reaching steady state, 4 to 5 half-lives are required. Means after 4 to 5 half-lives, a drug reaches steady state. This is very important. You have to remember. It has been asked in various competitive examination many times. Half-life is given by formula. Half-life is equals to 0.693 into Vd divided by Cl, where Vd is volume of distribution and Cl is clearance. Half-life is constant for a drug following first order kinetics. In previous session, we have already discussed about first order kinetics, and in that particular session, we have also learned that half-life is constant for a drug following first order kinetics. Now, we will discuss in this session why is it so? Because we know volume of distribution is a constant parameter, means for a particular drug, Vd remains constant. In case of half-life, first order case, the clearance is also constant. Why is it so? Because we know clearance is rate of elimination upon plasma concentration. We have already learnt about it, that clearance is rate of elimination upon plasma concentration. So in first order kinetics, rate of elimination is directly proportional to plasma concentration. So the ratio of these two always remains constant. Means the factor by which rate of elimination rises, that's by that same factor plasma concentration will rise. So the ratio of these two will always remain constant. So clearance is constant in case of first order reaction. So if clearance is constant, volume of distribution is constant and 0.693 is already a constant, then half-life is constant in case of first order reaction. After reaching a certain peak concentration called steady state, the plasma concentration becomes constant. After reaching a certain peak concentration, if a drug is administered by IV infusion, then the concentration rises, and after reaching a certain concentration, a certain peak, it becomes constant. So this particular constant region is known as steady state plasma concentration. After reaching the steady state plasma concentration, if we stop the drug administration into the body, then what happens? The plasma concentration starts declining. Okay. We will consider first case, that rise in plasma concentration. If we are administering an IV infusion into a patient, so how the plasma concentration will rise if the drug follows first order kinetics? Initially, in first half-life, the plasma concentration will reach 50% of its peak concentration, of its steady state concentration. In second half-life, it will become 75%. Means 50%, after reaching 50%, the remaining 50% is 25%. So 50 plus 25 is 75%. Now half of 25 is 12.5%. So the next addition will be of 12.5. So in third half-life, the plasma concentration will be 87.5. As we can see, in the first half-life, the plasma concentration rises to 50% of its peak value. Let it be 100 over here. So a 50% of 100 is reached in first half life. Then the half of 50% means 25% is reached in second half life, and in third half life it becomes 87.5. During fall in plasma concentration, that is when the drug administration is stopped. So after stopping the drug administration, the plasma concentration begins to fall. So in first half life it will become 50% of its initial concentration. In first half life, as we can see from the graph, the plasma concentration is 50% of its highest concentration or peak concentration. In second half life it will become 25%, because half of 50% is 25, so 50 minus 25. Now half of 25 is 12.5. So in third half life the plasma concentration will be 50 minus 25 plus 12.5, means it will be 12.5, means in short 25 minus 12.5, so it will be 12.5. For practicing MCQs and to learn important one-liners, follow GPET Kaksha on Instagram. The link of the same is given in description. Study well, keep yourself motivated, always keep smiling. Stay tuned for next topic, that is affinity and intrinsic activity. Thanks a lot.